Hello, everyone. Welcome. My name's Richard Kay, for those who aren't familiar with me. We've been running Zoom rehearsals with the York Phil since March. We've had 33 Zoom rehearsals, very much keeping the choir going. Now, as I'm sure you're all aware, Christmas is such an important time for choirs, such a busy time for choirs. And very much the case for the York Phil. As much as any other choir, it's a hugely important time of year for us, December. And the fact that we're not able to perform our concerts is devastating, really. It's a blow socially, it's a blow psychologically, it's a blow financially, let's be honest. But more important than that, we're missing the sense of community. We're missing the joy that we get from singing for and along with our loyal Christmas audiences. So we thought that the most appropriate way to do a virtual online concert would be, rather than in the summer we live streamed a concert, but rather than that, have a more informal event where we can actually see each other's faces and we can see each other singing on Zoom. Now, Zoom, for those who are unfamiliar with Zoom, firstly, where have you been the last 8 months? But secondly, if you are unfamiliar with Zoom, don't worry, I'll give you a brief rundown. It has its advantages and disadvantages. The advantage of Zoom is you do quite literally get the best seat in your house. You can watch in your slippers if you like, and the refreshments tend to be exactly to your liking. The disadvantages are, of course, we can't necessarily all hear each other. We can't sing together because of different internet speeds. It would all be cacophonous. So whilst hopefully we'll see each other's smiling faces, we'll see each other singing along, I will ask that you remain muted if that's all right. Not just because I like the sound of my own voice and I don't want to be distracted, but because it wouldn't work, unfortunately. But it is great to see you. Now, there are other ways of communicating. Some people have found it already. There is the chat button where you can post messages to everybody, or you could post messages just to individual people, private messages. So feel free to use that and catch up with friends old and new. You can also share files, which is what I'm going to do now whilst talking, just in case you don't have the words to the community carols, because there are going to be community carols, as there are with our carol concerts every year, and we would love you to sing along. So I'm just trying to find those carols, and it's just brought me to the wrong file. So I'll just talk a little bit whilst multitasking, which isn't something I do all that naturally. But I'm just sharing the words to the community carols on the chat there. So if you don't have them, you can always download them from there. Great. I'm also going to be sharing the screen with you so you can see some videos. Because what have we got tonight? Well, we've got a mixture of past Christmas performances from York Philharmonic Male Voice Choir performances at the Castle Museum, which we did for over 50 years, and some performances from The Merchant Adventurers, which we did for 3 years following that. We don't have any footage, but we have some photos from the 3 years following that, where we were in the De Grey rooms, and we do have some video from last year, where we went to our new home, our rehearsal venue of the Citadel in Gillygate. So we're going to play some videos there. We're also going to share some favourite CD recordings of carols that we've made in the past, and they'll be accompanied by some photo slideshows that are put together by Dave Todd, or photos that many of the choir have sent in, and we've got some very impressive photographers, and there's also some just lovely, lovely memories from those photo slideshows. And then we've got some new virtual tracks that we've recorded over the last, well, compiled over the last few weeks, from around 100 individual recordings that have been sent in, and we've got tracks to put together there. So enough of me talking. We need to start with a community carol, and we're going to sing O Come All Ye Faithful, and we'll be able to watch ourselves singing it, those of us who were there in 2011, from Kirkgate. So please do join in. Don't unmute yourself if that's all right, but please do join in.
Oh, God.
was from Kirkgate, which was our home in the Castle Museum for over 50 years. And we always wore Victorian dress. It was a wonderful thing to do. We then moved on to the Merchant Adventurers and Fossgate, where we became a little bit more classic with our tailoring. We wore our best dinner jacket, our DJs, and coloured bow ties. As you will see in this next offering, one of the favourites of the choir, Silent Night. Silent Night there from 2013. I hope there were a lot of people singing along there. Obviously, when I've got share screen on here, you can't see everyone, but you should see a little bar of faces along the top or along the side, depending on your setup. And you can scroll along there and see everyone here. Goodness me, there's loads of us. We've got 126 participants, but obviously there are more than one person per screen on many. So it's maybe someone could do a little tot up of how many we have. It'd be good to know a total. So there we have it. We were dressed more recently in our DJs there, as we have been in recent years when we changed the concerts to Christmas traditions at the De Grey Rooms and then at the Citadel. Obviously, we're a little bit more informal in our garb today. I see a lot of Christmas jumpers, which is great. We put no requirement on what the dress code should be this evening. Although I do hope that all the choir members are wearing the regulation coloured socks. I won't be asking for proof. So next we have a reading. Now, we have readings that are recorded and we have readings that are live this evening, a mixture of them. When they're live, I'll come off this share screen and we'll ask the person who's reading to unmute themselves and you'll be able to pin their picture so you can see them large rather than just a small face if you want to. But this first one is a reading from Graham Kay, lovely young chap. He's been a member of the choir, not quite as long as me, but he's got a reading for you. A poem by Joanna Fuchs.
A seasonal poem by Joanna Fuchs. Are we too grown up to feel a thrill when we light the Christmas tree? Are we immune to cookies, Christmas cards, and Christmas glee? Are we too adult to ooh and ah at the Christmas candle glow? Are we blasé about our gifts? Do we shun the mistletoe? Are we too mature for carols, for merry or for jolly? Do decorations leave us cold, the ornaments and holly? Fat chance! We'll never grow too old to love the Christmas magic. A year without a Christmas would be boring, even tragic. So bring it on! The candy canes, the feasting and good cheer. Oh, Christmas, lovely Christmases! You're the highlight of the year.
Many thanks, Dad. Yeah. We need to get in the Christmas spirit this year more than ever, don't we? And hopefully this is helping to do so. So next we have one of these virtual tracks that we've assembled in the last few weeks. We've got Ding Dong Merrily on High. Now, I could bring it off share screen and you'd see members of the choir dotted across the five or six screens that we have. Singing along, but I thought, you know, you might sort of miss the overall effect. So we recorded ourselves singing along to the virtual track at last Monday's rehearsal. So you can see more faces on the screen here, and it'll all be out of sync because obviously the different speeds of the internet at different people's houses makes it so. But here we are singing Ding Dong Merrily on High.
Ding dong merrily on high, in heaven the bells are ringing. Ding dong merrily the sky is rimmed with angels singing. Steeple bells be swung, and ye oi oi oi, by priests and people sung. Beautifully prime, your matching shiny ringers.
May you beautifully prime,
your meat and song ye singers.
Hosanna
in excelsis. Hosanna in excelsis.
There we have it, a virtual track put together over the last few weeks. And a huge thanks to Helen Smith, our pianist, who not only recorded the piano, but recorded the bells as well. Very exciting to have bells as well for that. Thank you so much for all your support, Helen. She's recorded so much piano for me to sing along to and then for everyone else to sing along to. So there we go. Just having a quick look at chat. Is it possible to make the screen so I can get my sound button? I'm having difficulty getting it right. Oh, I don't know, Chris. I'm not sure. I think once I share the screen, I think it's down to your settings. But if you hover over the bottom, you might be able to see where your sound is. But we'll be coming out of share screen soon. So hopefully that should help. After the next song, in fact. There's all sorts of technical things going on. I'm sure lots of other people will be far more competent than I am at this, but hopefully it's working relatively well. It just stops and starts at the start of tracks a little bit, as I remember to mute myself, but that then stops the track. So apologies for that. Next, we've got a CD recording from a CD I believe we made in 2011. And this is a song, Quem Pastores. And to accompany this, we have a delightful selection of photos, which show all sorts, from choir trips to past Christmas events. And you'll see a lot of faces, familiar faces, old faces of people who are no longer in the choir for whatever reason. It's a real joy to watch. So enjoy Quem Pastores and this slideshow that Dave's put together. Really wonderful to see those photos. Thank you for everyone for sending those in. Just lovely to see and remember members who are no longer with us, not least Eileen Gray, whose piano you heard there on the recording, but there were plenty others, Tony Ward, Jim Rain, Jim Waggett, Peter Reed, many very familiar and friendly faces and much loved members of the choir who are no longer with us. I've come off share screen so we can all see each other. Oh, this is exciting now, isn't it? Excellent. In the top corner, you'll see a thing that says view. If you wanted to click on it on speaker view, you would see the person who's speaking in over the majority of your screen. So you'll be looking at me at the moment. Sorry about that. You'll soon be seeing the speaker who's going to do the next reading. But if you'd like to see all the faces, click on gallery view and then you'll see them all there. I hope that makes sense. So we have a reading for you. And I'm going to ask Ian Revel to unmute himself. I'll be quiet and I'll let you take it away. Sam's Christmas pudding, Ian.
Thank you. Thank you, Richard. And greetings, everyone. Yes, Old Sam's Christmas Pudding, written by Marriott Edgar, but performed by Stanley Holloway, who more famous for his other poems, which you know, with great delight in the past. But this one, the Christmas one. It was Christmas Day in the trenches in Spain in Peninsular War, and Sam Small was cleaning his musket, a thing as he'd ne'er done before. They'd had him inspected that morning, and Sam had got into disgrace, for when Sergeant had looked down the barrel, a sparrow flew out in his face. The Sergeant reported the matter to Lieutenant Bird then and there. Said Lieutenant, "How very disgusting. The Duke must be told of this here." The Duke were upset when he heard. He said, "I'm astonished I am. I must make a most drastic example. There'll be no Christmas pudding for Sam." When Sam were informed of his sentence, surprise rooted him to the spot. 'Twere much worse than he'd expected. He thought as he'd only get shot. And so he sat cleaning his muskets and polishing barrel and butts, whilst the pudding his mother had sent him lay there in the mud at his foot. Now the centre that Sam's lot were holding ran round a place called Badajoz, where the Spaniards had put up a bastion, and ooh, what a bastion that was. They pounded away all the morning with canister, grape shot and ball, but the face of the bastion defied them. They made no impression at all. They started again after dinner, bombarding as hard as they could, and the Duke brought his own private cannon, but that weren't an ape of good. The Duke said, "Sam, put down the musket and help me to lay this gun true." Sam answered, "You best ask your favours for them you give pudding to." The Duke looked at Sam so reproachful. "And don't take it that way," said he. "Us generals has got to be ruthless. It hurts me more than it did thee." Sam sniffed at these words, kind of sceptic, then looked down the Duke's private gun and said, "We best put in two charges. We'll never bust bastion with one." He tipped cannonball out of the muzzle and took out the wadding and all. He filled barrel chock full of powder, then picked up and replaced the ball. He took a good aim at the bastion and then said, "Right, old Duke, let her fly." And the cannon fed jumped off her trunnions, and up went the bastion sky high. The Duke, he weren't half elated. He danced round the trench full of glee and said, "Sam, for this gallant action, you can hot up your pudding for tea." Sam looked round to pick up his pudding, but it wasn't there nowhere about. In the place where he had left it lay the cannonball he'd just tipped out. Sam saw in a flash what had happened. By an unprecedented mishap, the pudding his mother had sent him had blown Badajoz off the map. That's why fusiliers wear to this moment a badge which they think's a grenade. But they're wrong. It's a brass reproduction of the pudding Sam's mother once made.
Thanks ever so much for that, Ian. Oh, that's a great, great poem. Thank you very much for that. Really good and expertly delivered. And I just know, and I remember from previous concerts, just how much you enjoy saying, "And ooh, what a bastion that was." great stuff. I've just put in the chat a link. I mentioned at the start that Christmas is a time, a lucrative time for our choir, doing as many concerts as we do. And financially, as with many other organisations, we have taken a big hit this year. We are a registered charity, and we do need charitable donations to continue. Now, this is very much a free to participate and join in event, and I wanted it to be just that. But if there were any inclination to make a donation, then there is a Just Giving link posted on chat there. There is absolutely no expectation or requirement, but I just thought I'd put it out there. Good. So we're all going to sing together now, and we're all going to see each other singing together, which is quite exciting because we haven't got a video to share with you. I'm not going to put it on share screen, but we are going to sing along with a virtual track that we've put together of It Came Upon a Midnight Clear. Now, obviously, this is SATB, soprano, alto, tenor, bass, this arrangement. It's without piano. You can just sing the tune if you'd like, but if you fancy singing with one of the other sections, that's great. You may wonder how a male voice choir can sing SATB. Well, aha, we are blessed because at Christmas, we are joined by a group of ladies who sing with us. And they were called the Kirkgate Ladies when we sang for many years at Kirkgate in the Castle Museum. Then we moved to the Merchant Adventurers. They were called the Fossgate Ladies. Last year we were at the Citadel. They were called the Gillygate Ladies, I assume. I mean, far be it from me to suggest that they get around, but, you know, anything is better, though, than the 3 years we were at the De Grey Rooms, where I guess they were the De Grey Ladies. But we're very grateful to them for joining in with the chaos that is and the stressful event that is recording yourself singing solo and sending it off for me to judge, no, to put together. But it's made for a lovely track for us all to sing along to. You will have to guess the key. You'll hear it as you start, but I then expect you all to be singing along. Here we go. It Came Upon a Midnight Clear.
It came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old. From angels bending near the earth to touch their hearts of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from hands all gracious King. The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing. Still through the cloven skies they come with peaceful wings unfurled, and still and the whole world sent back the song.
Thank you so much to all the singers who sent in their tracks to put together for that. It is a terrifying thing to do. It requires bravery, not to mention a certain element of technical know-how to do these things. And I can see some friends joined us from the Leeds Male Voice Choir, which is lovely to see you chaps. You know all too well how scary that is as well. So I'm full of gratitude to you for recording your parts and sending them to me. Thank you ever so much. And hopefully you agree the result is pretty lovely. We've got another reading, albeit a very short one for you now, from James Elliott. And I will let you unmute yourself, sir.
In the monastery at Christmas. At a monastery high in the hills, the monks observe a strict and rigid vow of silence. Only at Christmas, and only by one monk, and only with one sentence, is this vow allowed to be broken. One Christmas, Brother Thomas is selected to speak, and he stands up, and he says, "I really like the mashed potatoes we had with the Christmas turkey." He sits down, and there is complete silence for another 365 days. The following Christmas, Brother Michael is selected, and he stands up to speak, and he says, "The mashed potatoes are really cold and lumpy and horrible, and I hate them." And he sits down. There is complete silence, this being a leap year, for 366 days, at which Brother Paul is selected to speak, and he stands up and he says, "I'm fed up with all this constant petty bickering."
Thank you, James. Beautifully delivered.
Yeah, that's it.
I didn't get it.
What a punchline.
Very good. Punchline.
And you can see people applauding if you can't hear them. Ah, that wonderful sound of silent applause. So we've got three songs for you now, starting with, and I'm just going to go to the share screen so that I can share this with you. Here we go. Oh, good. It's working. That's good. First, we've got We Three Kings of Orient Are, taken from our last Christmas CD, with some festive photos that have been sent in and compiled as a slideshow. Here we go.
Sowing, sighing, bleeding, dying.
There we go. Lovely selection of photos. Thank you for sending those in. I see there's some chat happening. Is there anything I need to address here? Oh, people saying they love the poem. Thank you. Yeah, that was good. Direct message button. So hello, everyone. Lovely to see you, Anne. Lovely to see everyone. Do use the chat button by all means. It's great to see your messages. Unfortunately, when I click on them, it then stops the video. So I'll try not to do that too much. But it is great to see you all. And 121 screens are currently tuned in, which is wonderful. We've got some video footage from an old concert now. I think this is taking us back to Kirkgate and a great song that we still love singing, The Star Carol. Good ending, isn't it? A good ending to a song there. We enjoy belting that one at the end. We've got lots of comments coming in, which is really great. Can't see shared video, Andrew. I'm sorry about that. Oh, dear me. We'll see if we can do something about that, although I'm not entirely sure what I can do myself. Do please make sure you keep yourselves muted during the videos, because I can't then mute people because it stops the videos. So if you can stay muted, that's great. Then we don't get any feedback. Takes you back. Yes, indeed it does, Janet. And happy birthday for tomorrow. Really lovely, says Anne. Lovely evening. So good to see everyone. Share happy memories. Cynthia, it's great to see you. And what else have we got? message from Sheila saying it's difficult enough to cope with 21 participants. Yeah, I know what you mean, Sheila, but we're getting there. We're doing well. We've got another virtual track to share with you now, which we recorded ourselves singing at our last rehearsal, so we've got it on a video. This is Somewhere in the Darkness, a relatively new song for us, but one that we very much enjoy singing. And well, hopefully it speaks for itself. I think this recording has come together really nicely. So hopefully you'll agree with me. Remember to unmute myself, that always helps. Such a lovely song, and great to hear everyone taking part with that. It's difficult recording these things without a conductor. Singing along to tracks and hearing a metronome, very difficult. As I mentioned in Leeds Male Voice Choir, we've got members from the Rydell Voices here as well, as they know all too well, it's tricky to do. Choirs need a conductor, don't they? And when we were watching the footage of Kurt Gate, when we're singing the Star Carol just two tracks ago, I meant to mention Berry, of course, who we miss greatly. She's been at the rehearsals all this term, leading the warm-ups for us, which is great. And we can't wait until we have her stood in front of us again, properly keeping us in line and cracking the whip. Hopefully not too long. We wait and see. Who knows what next year has to offer so far. Right, we've got time now for a... Community Carol. I want everyone joining in. I just need to make sure I'm sharing the right thing. Here we go. So we're going to sing Once in Royal David City. Again, it's unaccompanied, so you will hear the key as the singing starts, but you can catch up, I'm sure. And again, thank you to everyone who's recorded this, the ladies as well. It's been a great thing to do. Here we go. Once in Royal David City.
Once in Royal David's city stood a lonely cattle shed, where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother one, Jesus Christ the little child. He came down to earth from heaven, who is God and Lord of all, and his shelter was a stable, and his cradle was a stall. With the poor and mean and lowly, lived on earth a Saviour holy. And our eyes at last shall see him, through his own redeeming love. For that child so dear and gentle is our Lord in heaven above. And he leads his children on to the place where he is gone. Not in that glory stable, with the horses standing by, we shall see him, but in heaven, set at God's right hand on high, where light stars the children
Wonderful. Who tackled the descant at the end, I wonder? Oh, it's quite high, isn't it? Well done, well done. Some gents putting their hands up. Very good. I'm pleased to see that. Good. Some lovely messages coming in. Great singing. Thank you very much. One or two tears here. Oh, it is quite emotional, isn't it? But for all the right reasons, I hope. And we've got members of the Pocklington Singers here with us too. So welcome to you. Choral singing, even though sometimes choirs like to compete at festivals, choral singing really isn't a competitive thing, I don't think. We're all so supportive of each other, different choirs, and we just do it for the love of it. And it's great to see other people here supporting us. Thank you very much. Time for another reading now. And we've got Pudding Charms being read for us by Peter Smith. If you'd like to unmute yourself, Peter, I'll then be quiet.
Pudding Charms by Charlotte Pruitt Coate. Our Christmas pudding was made in November. All they put in it, I quite well remember. Currants and raisins and sugar and spice, orange peel, lemon peel, everything nice. Mixed up together and put in a pan. When you've stirred it, said Mother, as much as you can, we'll cover it over, that nothing may spoil it. And then in the copper, tomorrow we'll boil it. That night, when we children were all fast asleep, a real fairy godmother came a creep. She wore a red cloak and a tail steepled hat, though nobody saw her but Tinker the cat. And out of her pocket a thimble she drew, a button of silver, a silver horseshoe, and whispering a charm in the pudding pan dropped them. Then she flew up the chimney directly she dropped them, and even old Tinker pretended he slept. With Tinker a secret is always kept. But nobody knew until Christmas came round, and there in the pudding, the treasures are found.
Many thanks for that, Peter. Thank you very much. Wonderful. Continuing the theme of different choir members here. Lovely to see Sue Gwynn here, who used to lead the Redillion Singers. Lovely to see you. We've competed against and lost many competitions to the Redillions in our time. Great to see you. Excellent, Peter. Absolutely. Some great feedback for you. So many happy memories. When did myself and our kid murder away in a manger from the balcony in Kirkgate, 1974? Oh, yes. Oh, that's going back. Yeah, it's Kirkgate happened for many, many years. I don't think we've got any original Kirkgate members here, have we? It started that first year of the 52. Many, many happy memories. Right, going back to share screen, because we're back to the singing now. And we've got Joy to the World. Now, with this one, we have some photos accompanying it. Here we are. And here we go. Yes, yes, it is going to work. We have some budding photographers. And basically, the joy of the world is being shown while we sing Joy to the World. To the world there. Brilliant. A lovely selection of photos. Thank you for sending those in to Dave, and thank you, Dave, for putting them together. I should have said earlier, with the footage that we had from Kirkgate and Fossgate as well, thank you to Roger Gray for his video footage there. Great to see. Brings back many happy memories. Now another virtual track. I think our final virtual track of the evening that we put together over the last few weeks. It's one that's become a favourite in recent years, Schneewalzer. We're going to see ourselves singing along to our track from last Monday's rehearsal with a bit of impromptu choreography. Here is Schneewalzer.
Immer wieder denk ich dran, wann für uns das Glück begann. Nicht im Sommer, nicht im Mai, nicht im Herbst, mein Duft von Heu. Denn es war so Winterzeit, es war kalt und ganz beschneit. Doch im Saarland tanzten wir, und ich sagte verliebt zu dir. Denn Schnee, 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 Walzer bin ich sehr. Schnee, 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 Walzer lieb ich sehr.
There we have it. Perhaps not necessarily CD quality recordings, but it feels almost as if we're in the room together, and it's the best we can get, I think. Just lovely, says someone. Just lovely singing. Oh, thank you. Hoping for Away in a Manger. Oh gosh, sorry, Robin. We've let you down with Away in a Manger tonight. I'm sorry about that. Hopefully a good selection of songs for you. There is something that Robin might like shortly. I've just been asked by private chat to share the link again for that Just Giving site, so I'm just putting that on chat again, but I don't feel like I'm pushing it. It's just I was asked to share it. So now we have got a rather special recorded reading for you from a very special person.
Hello, my friends, both far and near. It's me. It's Father Christmas here. Well, goodness me, now what a year. We're all in need of Christmas cheer. You're stuck indoors far more these days, having fun in different ways, fussing over all your pets or gathered round the TV sets. But clouds can have a silver lining, so my hope is that you are finding joy from spending all your time with family and with friends online. Yet at this time there will be those less fortunate, as fortune goes. It's possible you'll come across some hardship, worry, fear or loss. Or maybe your health needs dictate that you must always isolate. My Christmas wish, therefore, is clear, that help for you is always near. And be assured, on Christmas Day you'll still get gifts. I'll find a way to carry out my yearly chores of bringing presents to your doors. I'll set about my joyous task by wearing a most festive mask. And to make sure I won't be late, I'll be the first they'll vaccinate. But this year, I fear, no time or place for us to meet up face to face. My opportunity is missed to hear about your Christmas list. I do so love to meet you all and hear your wishes big and small, to see your smiling face and hear just how good you have been all year. So Mrs. Claus proposed this time I send a film to you online. Online, I said, what clumsy me who struggles with technology. I'll get things wrong, I'll seem absurd, I won't remember my password. Well, Mrs. Claus, she fixed a stare and spoke in manner firm but fair. You claim to be this technophobe, and yet you travel round the globe. Why can't you simply film a greeting to all your friends instead of meeting? The man who manages each year to sprinkle Christmas joy and cheer, who trained the reindeer how to fly, can certainly give this a try. And so I find myself now coping with all the tech, and truly hoping to send to those I cannot see this message electronically. With any luck, from this machine, I'll beam to your computer screen. I'm all set up with my webcam. Now, can we do this? Yes, we can!
So there we go, even Father Christmas embracing technology. If he can, then surely we all can. So two more songs for you before we conclude. The first one is actually one from last year's concert that I wasn't able to attend, unfortunately, but it looked fabulous. It's a slightly grainy footage, I'm afraid. But it's where we sang with a children's choir, different children's choir each night, and we were in our new home of the Citadel on Gillygate, which is a great venue. This is Do You Hear What I Hear? I hope you do.
Prayer in the sky.
not a dry eye in the house that night, I'm sure. Really feels like Christmas now. That's good to hear. Oh, good stuff. We've got one more song. We will finish in the traditional way of Christmas traditions by singing We Wish You a Merry Christmas with some footage of us singing it from Fosgate a few years ago. Just thought I'd come off share screen briefly just to see you all one final time. Say a few thank yous as well. Obviously, the choir has kept going through thick and thin this year. And personally, I'd like to thank all the members who've embraced technology and joined us on Zoom each week. It really has been wonderful just to see each other, even if we couldn't hear each other live. We have tried to sing happy birthday to each other, and so we have heard each other. That's been less wonderful. Seeing each other has been better. Thank you to the musical team, to Graham, to Barry, to Helen, for all their support. Couldn't do it without them. Thanks also to the unsung heroes of the choir, the committee. Peter Smith, David Waring, Rob Smith, Mike Wash, Steve Poole. The work that these chaps do behind the scenes to keep everything going is phenomenal. And gents, you are incredibly generous in the time that you give. Thank you.
Richard, if I can interrupt one moment, I think you have missed one person out. And I think everybody ought to show their appreciation by putting their hands together for the amount of work that you've done over the year and putting this together. Thank you.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Peter. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. It's been a delight. And I can hear clapping because my daughter's clapping in the other room, which is great. thank you. That's very touching. And final thank yous from me to Dave Todd, who's done brilliantly with the Facebook socials every week after rehearsal, and with putting those slideshows together and generally helping me out, because I am quite a Luddite actually, and so helping with the videos and things. Well done, thank you for that. And to Colin for providing so much past footage and for all his support. Colin does an awful lot behind the scenes as well, so thank you ever so much. And finally, to all the brave singers who have succeeded in recording themselves and sending their recordings to me. It's great to have these virtual tracks, these tracks that we haven't got recordings of elsewhere. So it's fabulous that we've been able to do this. Thank you, every single one of you, for sending me the recordings. There was a time last week when they were coming in about every 5 minutes, and I was delighted and terrified in equal measure. It was great. Okay, we're going to finish off in the traditional way. I'll go back to share screen. Thank you so much for coming along. 122 screens is brilliant, and so many of them with multiple people. I'd love to know exactly how many people have attended. I think we could be pushing 200, which is excellent. I'll share the screen now, if I can remember how to do so. Where's it gone? Oh dear, hang on a sec. I might have just, oh no, I found it. I know what I'm doing, it's fine. We're not gonna fall at the last hurdle. So it just leaves us to wish you a very Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings we bring.
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Yes, indeed. A very, very Merry Christmas. Thank you all for your wonderful comments. Very kind. Hopefully there is that warm, fuzzy feeling now and that we're all feeling Christmassy. And it is truly lovely to see everyone. Just having a quick look at the comments because there's lots of comments come in at the chat before I finish it off. Well done, everyone. Fantastic concert. Thank you very much. Kirsty, Merry Christmas, everybody, from Steve. Thank you, Steve and Mary. Really enjoyed it. Meant so much to Dad, Mr. Waggett. I know he was Mr. Choir, really, wasn't he? It's lovely to see the Waggett family here in force. Sarah, thank you. Magical online concert. Thank you. Helen, thank you. Ho, ho, ho to one and all. Tenniel, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, so many comments. It's really lovely to see. Obviously, we wish we could be together next year, hey? Next year we will. Christmas traditions in person. That's my prediction. That's our hope. But for now, Merry Christmas. And can I wish you all a very happy and healthy 2021. Good night, all. Thanks
very
much.
Merry Christmas, Rich.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Hi, Richard. Thank you.
Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Thank you.
Christmas, everyone. Merry Christmas, everyone.